Hello friends, once again welcome to Diksha Mission JRF. This is our 14th day of Diksha Mission JRF. As of now, we were doing Diksha Mission JRF for the last 40 days. In the last 39 videos, we have discussed different topics from our NTA NET Paper 1 syllabus. We also have discussed different question papers. I hope all of you are going or all of you are doing good in your preparation. Make sure you are trying to utilize your available time maximum, because definitely there is a chance for extension of examination day. There is a chance, yet NTA official notification is yet to be out regarding the extension of examination date. And once everything is okay, once we will be getting back to normal, the examination dates, if you are still doing your post-graduation examination date, assignment submission, research works, other exams, NTA exam, everything will be coming in a stretch. Okay, so that everybody will be too hectic. At that time, you will not get much time for your preparation. So make sure you are utilizing this available time to the maximum extent. You are going through all the topics of our NTA Paper 1 syllabus. Okay, we have already provided you a Diksha progress sheet in which we have arranged all the topics in a tabular-wise manner so that you can tick or you can mark your status of preparation, like the topics you have covered and the topics you have revised, the topics yet to be covered, extra. If you want to download it, you can just go to the YouTube description or you can be a part of our WhatsApp broadcast list. Okay, so at the same time, before going to today's topic, make sure you are doing your task. We have the task number 40 today. The link for downloading the question paper of task number 40 is also available in the YouTube description, and the link for answer key of yesterday's task number 39 is also available in the YouTube description. Make sure you download it from there. If you face any difficulties in downloading, you can be a part of Diksha Paper 1 WhatsApp broadcast, in which we will be sending you directly the WhatsApp material, the PDF materials of the question papers, both answer key as well as the question papers. So as to join the Paper 1 free WhatsApp broadcast, you can send join to 9847478690. We also have broadcast for other subjects like economics, commerce, psychology, social work, extra. If you want to join it, you can go to the YouTube description. The detail, number, format, link, everything is available there. And if you would like to know more about Diksha online courses, previous question paper course, mega practice course, extra, you can visit our website www.dikshaclassroomcourse. So as to get previous question papers, previous videos of Diksha Mission JRF, explanation of 2019 December question papers, all the 10 shifts of 2019 December question papers, categorized question papers, extra, you can visit our YouTube channel, that is Diksha Classroom. You can go to the playlist and you can select whichever video you want to go through. Okay, so that's it regarding utilizing various Diksha platforms to the best for your Paper 1 preparation. Make sure along with this, you are also doing well in your Paper 2 preparation. It's also very important because, you know, Paper 1 gives you almost 100 marks, that is 33.33% of the total, and Paper 2 gives you almost 200 marks, that is 66.6% of the total exam. So make sure you are giving stress to or importance to Paper 2 topics also. Okay, so let's go to today's video. Today we are going to discuss a topic from people, development and environment. Okay, so we are going to discuss MDG or Millennium Development Goals. We have two set of developmental goals as a part of our syllabus, that is Millennium Development Goals and Sustainable Development Goals. In today's video, we'll be discussing MDG or Millennium Development Goals, and tomorrow, Diksha Mission number 41, we'll be discussing Sustainable Development Goals. So friends, let's go to Millennium Development Goals. So friends, in this video, we are discussing about Millennium Development Goals, which is also known as MDG. As we have said, it's a very important topic from our people, development and environment. So we have, I hope you know what is this Millennium Development Goals and Sustainable Development Goals. Regarding Sustainable Development Goals, we'll be discussing in the next video. All of them or both of these are a set of goals that are decided by the UN or United Nations, which has to be fulfilled by member countries within a stipulated period of time. And it was everything started from the beginning of the millennium, especially in the beginning of 2000. In September 2000, UN Assembly unanimously adopted the UN Millennium Declaration. And as a part of this Millennium Declaration, at that time, 189 member states of the United Nations Committee themselves asked for to create an agenda. Okay, so as to adopt a set of framework of policies so as to ensure or so as to remove all sort of instances of poverty and injustice. Okay, so this Millennium Declaration, the major objective behind this Millennium Declaration was to reduce the incidence of poverty and injustice throughout the world. As a part of that, UN postulated or UN proposed a new concept of development goals. Okay, so firstly, there was the Millennium Development Goals, then there was the Sustainable Development Goals. And Millennium Development Goals was adopted in the year 2000. And sustainable in 2015, we'll be discussing regarding that in the next video. So as per Millennium Development Goals, there are a set of 8 goals, 18 targets and 48 indicators. Okay, that was the number. Number is important. Millennium Development Goals, you have 8 goals, 18 targets and 48 indicators. And the year of beginning of Millennium Development Goals was in the year 2000 and the target year was 2015. Okay, so both Millennium Development Goals and Sustainable Development Goals have a target of 15 years. For Millennium Development Goals, it was 2000 with the target of 2015, and for Sustainable Development Goals, the beginning year was 2015 and the target year was 2030. Okay, 2030. So we have basically, as we have said, there are 8 goals. So these are the major 8 goals that are coming under Millennium Development Goals. Firstly, eradicate extreme poverty and hunger, achieve universal primary education, promote gender equality and empowerment, reduce child mortality, improve maternal health, combat HIV/AIDS, ensure environmental sustainability, a global partnership. Simply, these are the 8 goals. We'll be discussing all of them one by one. So firstly, we have one of the most important aspect or one of the most important step that every country in the world should adopt so as to remove any sort of poverty and injustice, that is eradicate extreme poverty and hunger. That was a first goal of Millennium Development Goals. Definitely, if we consider the different problems or challenges faced through by different countries throughout the world or by the humanity itself, we can say poverty is one of the most significant challenge. Okay, so that's the reason why Millennium Development Goals give first priority to eradication of extreme poverty and hunger. And as per this extreme poverty and hunger, there are different targets. We have the first target as half between 1990 and 2015, the proportion of people whose income is less than $1.25 a day. So all the countries has to take a statistics regarding count regarding their amount of people with income less than $1.25 with regards to the 90 level. It should be reduced to half by 2015. Okay, so then the second target, achieve full and productive employment and decent work for all, including women and young people. Okay, so the second goal was regarding productive employment and decent work. And the third target was half, again, the year between 1990 to 2015, the proportion of people who suffer from hunger. There is no need of getting confusing hearing the year 1990, even though it was started in the year 2000. In 1990 is taken as a base year for the statistics. We have seen it regarding our Kyoto Protocol also. In both cases, in both
target or the commitment period first and commitment period second. We have the base year as 1990. So these are the first three or three targets regarding eradication of extreme poverty and hunger. Remember, there is no need of studying in detail regarding the targets. Still, we will be discussing targets in one by one. It's because then you will remember it more easily. Okay, we are discussing the targets so as to make sure you will remember those targets. For our examination viewpoint, importance is goals. 8 goals are being asked. Targets are not asked usually. Then we have the second goal, achieving universal primary education. And the target is ensure that by 2015, children everywhere, boys and girls alike, will be able to complete a full course of primary schooling. So as per the second target, it's necessary or it's important so as to ensure the children throughout the world get full course of primary schooling. Okay, so that was a single target that comes under universal primary education. Remember, as of now, there are 18 targets we have said. So in some under particular goals, there may be 2 targets, under particular there may be 3 targets, but under the achieve universal primary education, you have one single target. Okay, next we have the third goal, goal number 3, promote gender equality and empower women. Okay, so promoting gender equality and empowering women is the third most important goal out of the Millennium Development Goal. And there is one target under this, that is eliminate gender disparity in primary and secondary education, preferably by 2005, and in all levels of education, no later than 2015. So as per the third goal, that is promoting gender equality and empowering women, all sort of gender disparity should be eliminated before 2015, and gender disparity in primary and secondary education should be removed or eliminated preferably by the year 2050. So that's regarding the goal number 3. Next we have the goal number 4. Goal number 4 discusses regarding reducing child mortality. Okay, a very important aspect regarding ensuring the health of the child, because there are many developing countries in which the number of infant mortality rate is very, very high, of huge concern. India is such a country. So goal number 4 is to reduce child mortality, and as per the this goal, the target is to reduce by 2/3 between 1990 and 2015 the under 5 mortality rate. So goal number 4 states that the child mortality rate should be reduced by 2/3 by the target year of 2015. Okay, by the target year of 2015, it is supposed that all the member countries will reduce the child mortality rate below the age of 15 by 2/3. Next we have goal number 5. Don't forget, we have 8 goals under Millennium Development Goals and 17 goals under Sustainable Development Goals. So the 5th goal was improving the maternal health. In the 4th goal, we have discussed about reducing child mortality, and the similar and related goal comes under goal number 5, that is improving maternal health. There are 2 targets coming under improving maternal health, and the first target is to reduce by 3/4. Again, the target years are between 1990 and 2015. So countries have to reduce by 3/4 between 1990 and 2015 the maternal mortality ratio. So there should be a reduction of maternal mortality ratio by 3/4 between the years 1990 and 2015. Then second target coming under the same goal is to, by 2015, universal access to reproductive health should be provided throughout the world or throughout the countries. So there are 2 targets coming under improving maternal health. Firstly, deals with the reduction of maternal mortality ratio, and second one deals with universal access to reproductive health. So next we are moving to goal number 6. Goal number 6 discusses about combating HIV or AIDS, malaria and other diseases. Okay, goal number 6 discusses with combating HIV or AIDS, malaria and other diseases. So under this there are 3 goals. Okay, total we have 18 goals. So under this there are 3 goals. So the first goal is halving the we'll be making the amount, we have to reverse the spread of HIV AIDS. Okay, so by 2015, the countries have to have the halt of or the spread of HIV AIDS, or the presence of HIV AIDS should be spreading, should be reduced, and there should be reversing of the spread. Okay, so that's the first target. And the second target is by 2010, universal access to treatment for HIV and AIDS should be provided for all those who need it. So target, the second target coming under the sixth goal says that universal access to treatment for HIV AIDS for all those who need it. Then you have target third, there should be halting of malaria and other major diseases also. There should be a half halting of malaria and major diseases by 2015, and there should be a reversing of the incidence of the occurrence of such type of diseases. So that is goal number three. Next we have, sorry, that is a target number three coming under goal number seven. Next we have the goal number seven, that is ensure environmental sustainability. Okay, ensuring environmental sustainability is the seventh or the penultimate goal, and it has seven targets, and sorry, it has four targets under it. Okay, four targets are coming under ensuring environmental sustainability. The first target is to integrate the principles of sustainable development into country policies and programs and reverse the loss of environmental resources. So by this goal, the UN aims that the countries should adopt necessary policies so as to ensure the concept of sustainable development. We have discussed regarding sustainable development in our environment, where the Brundtland Commission, which gave the concept of, or which explained the concept of sustainable development, that is sustainable development is, okay, meeting the needs of the present generation without compromising the needs of the future generation. Okay, so that's the first target coming under ensuring environmental sustainability. Then we have the second target as reducing biodiversity loss, and by 2020 there should be a significant 2010 there should be a significant reduction in the rate of loss. So the second target discusses regarding reduction of biodiversity loss. Then the third target says that by 2015, okay, there should be halving of the, okay, the proportion of the population without sustainable access to safe drinking water and basic sanitation. So the total number of people, coming having or without sustainable access to safe drinking and water and basic sanitation should be reduced by half. That is the third target. And the fourth target is should be achieved by 2020. There should be a significant improvement in the lives of at least 100 million or 10 crore slum dwellers. So ensuring environmental sustainability discusses regarding adoption of sustainable development policies, reduction of biodiversity loss, provision for providing safe drinking water and basic sanitation. Along with that, it also discusses regarding significant improvement in the lives of at least 100 million slum dwellers. So that's goal number seven. Next, we are moving to the final goal coming under Millennium Development Goals, that is goal number eight, which discusses develop a global partnership for development. Okay, developing a global partnership for development is the eighth and the final goal, and there are three targets coming under this. First target is to develop a further and open, rule-based, predictable, non-discriminatory trading and financial system throughout the world. So it's all about promoting global cooperation. Next, addressing the special needs of least developed countries. That means it deals with providing special attention to least developed countries. Then the last target is addressing the special needs of landlocked developing countries and small island developing states. Okay, so the third target is to address the special needs of landlocked developing countries and small island developing states. Okay, so these are the first three goals. After this, we have fourth, fifth, and sixth goals also. The fifth goal discusses dealing comprehensively the debt problems of developing countries. Okay, so this goal also discusses regarding dealing with the debt problems of developing countries. So there should be comprehensive dealing of debt problems. throughout the world developing countries. And the fifth target is in cooperation with the pharmaceutical companies, providing access to affordable essential drugs in developing countries. Okay, it's also a very important aspect, especially we can see it in this corona lockdown period. The sharing of drugs between different pharmaceutical companies and countries throughout the world is very significant for sustaining humanity. So that's all about target number 5. And the last target number 6, in cooperation with the private sector, make available benefits of new technologies, especially information and communication. So the final targets coming under 8th goal or promoting development throughout the world says that there should be a cooperation with the private sector and the latest technologies should be made available for all the countries, especially developing and less developed countries. So that's it. So these are the 8 goals and 18 targets. It's not necessary you have to study the targets by heart. What is necessary is you have to study the goals by heart. A lot of questions are being asked.
So friends, that's all about this video discussing Millennium Development Goals from People Development and Environment. I hope you are clear with the concept. Make sure you are thorough with the different goals. A lot of questions has been asked from this particular topic regarding a select which among the following are Millennium Development Goals. They will be usually giving a mix of both Millennium Development Goals and Sustainable Development Goals. And you have to select which of them are MDG or which of them are SDG. So you should be thorough with all the goals. There is no need of going in details to indicators extra, but just be thorough with the 8 goals. Okay, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, Diksha Classroom. You press the bell icon so that you will get notification in proper time. And if you would like to download previous question paper ebooks and other previous question and study materials, you can visit our website www.dikshaclassroom.com. So that's all about this video. See you tomorrow, same time. Thank you.